and really just like focused on my grieving process. I've experienced four deaths in an 11-month time span, so it's been a lot. And they were all people very close to me, and this is the first time that I've ever experienced anything like that. My cousin passed away in a car accident, but we were raised like siblings. So that was really hard. And then my friend was murdered October 30th. That was really hard. And my grandpa passed January 20th. And then I had another loss in September. So it's just been like back to back.
They haven't even given you time to even grieve. Wow.
No, not really. So nice. I stepped away from everything to just focus on the business and the money and my health. And
yeah. So that's why you really took off from the internet for a while, to just like get some sanity. Like, you just needed to get a breather from the internet, because the internet could be so toxic, and you just wanted to get that toxic out of your life because you were grieving.
Well, grieving, and I'm on this like mental health journey where I'm just trying to get like healthy. And so trauma therapy, grief counseling, figuring out which antidepressants were really going to help me, you know, be able to push through all of this. I just went radio silent, because I've also curated, well, my page is missing at the moment, but I curated my page as well. I muted a lot of cast members, blog sites. I started following things that pages that interest me. So home design, different architects, food, animals, babies, women empowerment pages, Bible app pages. So that was really all I was seeing, because okay. The world is just so dark. And then I have a new practice where I get up, brush my teeth, wash my face, drink a large cup of water, and then I get on my knees, bow my head, fold my hands, pray, ask the spirit to just guide me to a scripture that will speak to something I'm going through, something I'm not sure how to overcome, something that's headed my way that I can't see yet. And then I, you know, take my shower, go on my walk, and then I tackle the day. I don't look at my phone until I'm done with my walk. So just kind of prioritizing my mental health in a very real way. And really just developing healthier practices.
Have you feel like those techniques actually is helping you with your mental health?
Oh yeah, for sure. Okay. Which, you know, clearly I was able to
a second. Hey, when you get back on social media, I mean, you're back in drama. Like, it's just like, wow. Like,
you took
this break, and then you get back on social media, make one comment, and your comment just like blows up. Like, wow.
Well, you know what's interesting about it is that, you know, people have said to me, oh, if it weren't for Fizz, or if it weren't for Love and Hip Hop, we wouldn't know you. That's true. I don't really clap back at people who say that. Like, that's fine. But then let's talk about the fact that my father's a 10-time Grammy Award winner. So when I made that comment, and don't get it fucked up, like, I thought I knew everything, and I didn't want to follow my dad's instructions, and I wanted to go from under that umbrella because I didn't understand the importance of artist development and music business. Berkeley, and I was like, what do I need to go to college for? I'm gonna sing, like, you know. And he just was like, you're making a mistake. But ultimately, at that point, I'm 18, he can't force me, and all he could do was wait for me to come back home, essentially back to the foundation, you know. And so I've made the mistake, I've written some of
but
the
did he like really disown you because of your
no, he didn't. Who disowned me?
Your father.
My bio dad, yeah, but not my dad.
Okay.
Yeah, no.
Because I had read it, and I was like, I wanted to ask her that.
No. But yeah, so I've written some of the biggest records of this century, and me not wanting to follow my father's instructions, I was ripped out. I was gypped of my publishing, my credits, like, and I knew better, but I was just eager, you know what I mean? And so when I made that comment, I didn't discuss her looks. I've seen people call hers. First of all, when I made the comment, I didn't talk about anything that, or address anything that she was not addressing in that video. That's for starters. Secondly, there were multiple, and I don't consider myself a celebrity. So there were multiple celebrities with verified badges that were commenting similar things, but weren't really elaborating on the business. And in this business, you have to have a tough skin. Clearly, I get beat down, like several blogs posted it. I already know the Shade Room following doesn't like me, right? Mm-hmm. But even when you break that down, I've never fucked their daddies, their mamas, their niggas, their bitches. I don't impact their bag. I ain't slapped none of their kids. Like none of that. So when you break that down, like it's a whole slew. The comments on the Shade Room are different than the comments on the Neighborhood Talk, Gossip of the City, and anywhere else I've seen it that it's been sent to me, right? Mm-hmm. And so when you process that, and I'm learning this in trauma therapy, like when you process stuff on that level, that was really when I came back why I don't even respond to that kind of negativity anymore. Because at the end of the day, you're really in here bashing me, my motherhood, my sanity, and you've never met me and I've literally never done anything to you. Those are the sick individuals, if we really want to keep it a buck. You got to be real ill to not like somebody so much so that you'll talk about some of the most, I don't see anybody else getting on TV and being that vulnerable and breaking the stigma. Cause let's also keep it above. Before I got on TV, what black man or woman do you know was on television advocating for mental wellness? I'll wait. Now all of a sudden, everybody wanna come out about how mental health is so important. Now, if I jump off a bridge tomorrow, it'll be them same motherfuckers talking about RIP. I feel so bad for her son. Oh my God, this is why y'all shouldn't bully people. And I've applied that same principle when I comment on general things, right? So
yes,
I made that comment about publishing. And at the end I said, he's a snake. Okay, well, you should have known how to handle your business. And she was saying, when I said, if it weren't for FNF, we wouldn't know you. I only said that because she said in the video, she said, and to the person that said, girl, you could have shut up, so could all of the other thousands of people that commented. And that's my fucking point.
I mean, y'all
y'all just don't like me. It's not the message, it's the messenger. Go to hell. So at the end of the day, she's in there talking about, he could have gave that beat to anybody, but he gave it to me. Without me, it wouldn't be no FNF. I'm the only one that can make an FNF. Okay, so let's break that down. If he gave that beat to Jane Doe, she's not going to write an FNF. Now, if motherfucking Metro Boomin comes and gives you a beat, it still wouldn't be FNF. Let's talk about it. If he had not given you that particular beat, you would not have FNF. And if it weren't for FNF, let's also fucking talk about it. The world wouldn't know you. If it were not for Love and Hip Hop and my tumultuous relationship with the father of my child and me being a basket case at one point, always on the internet crying about my contract, always on the internet crying about storylines and bullshit edits, always on the internet talking about, crying about being bullied about my motherhood. But you know what? At the end of the day, through therapy, I've had to learn it don't matter what anybody else say. My son loves the shit out of me. Right?
So, like, I'm lost as to why was your child even brought up into a situation like this? Like, so your child has nothing to do with this.
So, mind you, this exchange was a month ago. So I made that comment a month ago, 2 days after. So for everybody like, oh, she's always in some mess, watch this. 2 days after I made that comment, she slid into my DM. She led with, keep my name out of your mouth. What the hell is an old bitch like you so worried about a young bitch like me for when you don't even have custody of your son? You're worried about the wrong case. Now, if you go back and look at that screenshot, there are no DMs prior to that. I wasn't following this girl. She wasn't following me. Right? And you slid in. So it's giving fan behavior. You were a fan because you led with a Love and Hip Hop storyline. And you singled me out because you're a fucking fan and you got your funky little feelings hurt, Gonzo. That's really what happened. So even if you put the screenshot up, my first response was, wow. I think I said something like, watch yourself or tread lightly or something. And then I highlighted, I said, one, I didn't say anything negative about it. I know exactly what's going on. She reported the DMs.
Yeah, she gonna get her page back. It's just going, like, they, I guess they're doing an investigation, but it shouldn't even be this much, though. Like, I mean, do you have to go to court and all that for, in order for you to get the page back?
Like, I saw a comment under the neighborhood talk and they were like, oh, how did you guys get these? She sent them to you? No. I woke up to them DMing me and asking me. So when you
try to go into your page, that's when you was logged out from your page?
Mm-hmm.
And when you were logged out, did it tell you, like, okay, you have to get them your verify number, your and they're gonna send you like a confirmation?
My number like wasn't okay. My number, in the event that my social media was ever hacked, I never put my phone number on there. So I submitted my email, and they said that they would get back to me in 24 hours. We heard nothing until last night.
Wow. And honestly, so your number wasn't on your Instagram, so you wasn't able to get that little code or nothing like that?
Mm-mm.
Wow.
And
man,
so
that's
now
crazy.
And so now I'm broke. I've lost wages because I monetized my social media. I can't afford to give my son a Christmas. I don't know how I'm going to, like, buy groceries. You know, I could have made a lot of money for Black Friday and Cyber Monday. I could have put the link to my book in my Instagram bio. And now that's gone. So we've delayed the pre-sale options for the book because I'm poor.
Wow.
Yeah. So I'm gonna make a GoFundMe. You guys will be able to find it in my, I'm sorry, because I have to laugh to keep from crying, but I really am distraught. Like, I'm going to make a GoFundMe.
This has really made you lose money. Like, that's, your business has been tarnished because of this.
Yeah, and so I'm going to have to... You guys, it's really not funny. I'm really devastated, and financially I've been impacted. I had to close two bank accounts today because I just don't know where my money's gonna come from. And one of those bank accounts was attached to my social media.